Okay, guys, welcome to the CashNut charity stream.
Oh,
we are here with Andreas Rönnberg, lead level designer at Overkill Software, and gonna answer some questions for you guys.
Thanks for the follow.
Alright, Pedi, can you take over?
Yeah, hello guys, thanks for joining us. So today we're collecting money for cancer research, and we'll be interviewing Andreas, as Oka already said. First, can you tell us some basic information about you, what you did before you joined Overkill, and what you exactly do as a lead level designer?
All right, hey, thanks for letting me be on here. So yeah, I'm, you know, the lead level designer, and what I did before I started working at Overkill, I mostly worked with mods. Half-Life mods, to be precise, and I'm the guy behind Cry of Fear, the guy, one of the first games released on Greenlight, or I think it was the first game released on Greenlight, actually. And you know, I've been modding for a very long time, ever since I was 12. I'm 25 now, and that, you know, really made me interested in level design. And eventually I, you know, wanted to apply to Overkill, and I got a job back in 2014, just around the time when Hotline Miami was gonna be released. And ever since then I've been, you know, working with levels. And at first I started out as a level designer at Overkill, and eventually back in 6 months ago I became the lead level designer. And right now I'm helping out the level designers now, and you know, backing them up and assisting with planning and all the stuff around that. And you know, since we have had kind of a flat structure in the company before, and now we kind of try to move over to more hierarchy, I guess, and that's really needed since we're becoming so many now.
Okay, thank you. So if any of you guys have questions that are watching the stream, you can just post them in the chat, and we'll try to ask as many of them as we can. Please keep them focused on level design and heists, because that's his area of work. For now, we also have some questions from ourselves. First one is, will the Butcher and Locke get more heists in the future?
Yeah, we don't have any plans for that right now, but that's really something we want to expand on. I mean, I'm a big fan of Locke and the Butcher, and it's always great to see new contractors coming up. But I can't really promise anything, but I'm sure that's something we want to do and continue doing, and you know, evolve on the story behind those characters, I guess. But that's not really in the plan right now. But it probably will happen.
Okay. You're really the person behind Cry of Fear?
Yes, that's...
That's really me. Amazing. I had no idea.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's cool.
I love that game.
Cool, thank you.
One of the scariest crap I've ever played, honestly.
Yeah, it's a cool game. We've played that.
Yeah, really, really difficult. Especially if you only play with 5 saves.
yeah, on nightmare mode, yeah.
Yeah, that was horrible.
So we have a question from Confetti Chicken. What software do you do the level design in?
You know, we use our in-house engine called Diesel, and that's where we, as level designers, mock up our levels and script it, and then you know, we get artists helping out with their software. I'm not quite sure which software they are using, but at some occasions us level designers have to bring up Maya as well, and you know, adjust geometry around the levels, and yeah, sometimes that's needed for us level designers to do, but that's not very frequent. We mostly focus on Diesel, our in-house engine, and that's mostly where we work.
Okay, question from Sulimation. Will you make workshop maps available soon?
I mean, that idea sounds really cool. I hope that's something we can do, but since the engine is not released to public, I don't know if that's like possible. But I mean, that's up to producers and, you know, other leads to make happen, and that's not part of my position. So I'm not really sure, but it definitely sounds like a cool idea.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I agree. It will be really cool. Question, I don't know how to pronounce his name. Kael Sanguin asks, do you prefer to have inspiration for a heist, like Point Break or Hotline, or do you prefer to have carte blanche when creating a heist?
I mean, coming in, you know, with no idea behind something makes other ideas, you know, appear. And I think that's something we prefer to do. I mean, it's really fun to work with other studios and games and collabs, but making the games, the levels from scratch and with no ideas behind it, that usually, you know, brings up more awesome content, like you recently saw on the biker heists. I mean, a train level, that's fantastic, that's awesome. I think that's something we enjoy doing.
The fact that you have to make a moving terrain, since the train is moving, that was quite impressive, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we definitely had our doubts on that, but we did a prototype, and it seemed to really work out, and that was awesome.
Because I was actually assuming that when I heard there was going to be a train heist, I was assuming that it's going to be only inside, because then it would be easier to make the terrain move, like, from side to side. But... Yeah, it looks really amazing.
We got 3 donators. Thank you so much, Lucre, if that's how you pronounce the name. Thank you so much for donating. And we have Creepy Aaron Pie. He says, love that you guys have dedicated your time in this. Thank you so much, man.
Thank you.
We have Piercing Mountain here.
Good luck with the charity stream, and keep the helmets flying.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you very much, man.
Talking about that, about the donations, we have rewards for our top 3 donators that I can tell you guys right now. The top donator at the end of the stream will get a Payday 2 loot bag with a signed Dallas mask, a money bundle, a t-shirt, and Dallas Wolf and Chains metal pins. So that's all real-life merch from the Overkill store. The mask will be signed by the Overkill developers. And then for the second and third top donator, they will receive a Dead by Daylight Steam key. So that's the new game that's right out right now, which is a horror survival game. So that might be cool to check out as well. And we're also gonna drop some random DLC keys in the chat, which I'm...
Sorry, was that a...
that's not a question.
Okay, sorry, I was reading the chats here and...
Yeah, no problem. I'll start with a Point Break heist. I'm gonna drop it in the chat between now and a minute, and the first one to activate it gets it, of course. So next question. We have a train now, but where is my boat? Asked by Fizzle Twist.
we've had like ideas of making a boat level. That's been something we've been wanting to do, but it's a lot of work to make it happen, and we want to do it right. So I hope we will do it someday, but it's not in our plan either. But we are definitely, like, you know, looking into it, and we want to try to do it at some point.
Okay. Let's see. A lot of questions coming in. When will there be a 7-day heist? Asked by NordPL.
Wow, that's so much work to do.
A 2-day heist is long enough, I would say.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And that too. I mean, it takes so long to play a 2-day heist or a 3-day heist even. Mm-hmm. A 7-day heist would just be exhausting for players. But I mean, we've been joking about it in the office. And
maybe it can be like a super ultra the last heist ever made thing, maybe. Just see how long you last. You're gonna be there for a whole day.
Yeah.
Yeah, as the mother of heist, just before you stop supporting the game, maybe.
But
before we move on to Payday 3.
But a 7-day heist. I mean, I can never say never, but I don't think that will happen. But we'll see. I mean, maybe. But you know, end of the game, we might do it. I don't know. Or maybe we'll be randomly, you know, picked. Kind of like a playlist of levels that becomes a 7-day heist. I don't know. But I mean, if that's just ideas. And,
Question from Just Eat a Pancake. How many hours do you have in Payday 2? I guess they mean with developing.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I think they mean both.
Or playing as well.
I haven't really looked recently at my own personal profile. I doubt I have that many hours at home, since I'm at home right now. But at work, I probably have, I mean, more than like 2,000 hours or something.
That's cool. There's a lot of questions going in. I don't know if you can answer this. When can we customize our safe house?
Yeah, I think Joachim answered that on the AMA. I can't remember what he said, but I can't really say that the exact release date or anything. But we are, you know, working on it as we speak. Not as we speak, but you know, at work. So it is in the making. We are definitely progressing, and it's gonna be awesome.
Okay, will there be a No Mercy heist from PHFC Attack?
We are working on more Payday 1 levels, but we haven't really chosen which levels to come next. But we are definitely now working on the remakes of those levels, and yeah.
So there will be more originals then.
Definitely, yeah. That's in our plan.
That's awesome.
Yeah, go ahead.
No, I wasn't gonna say anything.
Ah, okay.
No. I was just gonna say that a lot of people loved the heist because they were so different in the first game. So it's pretty obvious that they want them back in this game. So.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, indeed.
So next question is, will there be an Italian heister? Perhaps something related to the Italian mafia?
Everett?
No, not related to, but it's my question anyway.
Yes.
Because I'm Italian now.
Yeah, I'm sorry. That's like...
qualified.
Yeah, top secret.
The more people from like around the world in the Payday gags is really nice. I mean,
everyone of every nationality has somebody to play with.
Yeah, in 4 years maybe.
Yeah, French, German, Russian. It never ends.
Will you add an airport terrorist attack heist?
Remember, no mercy.
That reminds me of the No Russian from Modern Warfare 2.
Remember, no Russians.
I mean, that would be kind of morally bad.
Yeah, I agree.
Maybe you should have a warning, you can skip this mission in the beginning.
You can skip this mission. Yeah.
Or it's like censor to everyone except no one.
Yeah.
Will you add a heist in space?
Oh, come on.
Yeah, no. No.
If we could have space, but Liz couldn't have her boat, that would be fucking insulting.
But it would definitely be a Vlad mission, though.
Dictatorship like just donated 50 euros. Thanks, man.
Oh,
50
thank you.
Euros.
50 euros.
Yeah, that's better.
That's awesome.
And he said, did you guys heist the pixel raid? But I honestly keep up the good cause. Thank you, man. Thank you so much for donating.
Yeah, There are people saying it's kind of pixely on the stream, so...
Well, like, we can do a little about it, but last time I tried to do something about it. The FPS got, like, down to 7 or something. It was pretty weird, but I can mess with it a little round here later.
Yeah, also the total donations raised, it's not updating.
Yeah, well, I don't know, but... it updated now.
Oh, yeah, it just takes a while, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a lot of questions like, will there be this heist? Will it be a Trump heist or character pack?
Do you get to assassinate Donald Trump?
Oh god, man.
Ah, here's a good question. Which heist are you the proudest of?
Mm-hmm. That I made myself, I'm guessing.
Yeah.
Since when I was the regular level designer, I worked on... the first one I worked on was White Christmas. And the second was Car Shop, and then Meltdown, and then Birth of Sky, and then Gone Simulator. Mm-hmm. And I think the one that I'm personally most proud of my own levels, I think that would be Birth of Sky, because that's like technically the hardest one that we could achieve, because it's essentially like three levels in one level.
You have up in the sky, you have on the ground, and then you go down in the sewers and use a boat.
Yeah, exactly. So it's like, yeah, three levels in one. It was really tricky to do. And,
yeah, it was an amazing heist. Did you work on Beneath the Mountain also?
No.
Okay.
Hey, so one of you guys needs to repair.
Okay, I'm coming.
But just take my question. It's good.
What is your question?
It's you can in the announcement.
You can just ask him now.
Wait, I need to find it, man. I can't remember.
Afterwards, I can do I can do Fizzle's question in that case.
Wait, didn't you already?
Oh. No. Well, there's another one. Like Starbreeze made the Golden Green Casino heist, as you know. If you would have made the Golden Green Casino heist, is there anything you would have changed?
You mean Lion Game Lion made that?
Yeah, Lion Game Lion. Oops, sorry. I'm very sorry.
That's quite funny, actually, because when I started at Overkill, someone asked me to maybe make the casino as the first level, and we were laughing because, I mean, that's way too much work for, like, a starter. No, I can't really, on top of my head, come up with an A. I haven't really thought about what we could do differently. I think the map is really good as it is, yeah.
Did we have any more, Petty?
I can ask mine. Mm-hmm. Okay,
Someone asked how do you use a DLC code. I'll answer that first because I'm posting those codes in the chat. If you just copy the code and go to Steam, then in the left bottom corner, you can press add a game, then activate a product on Steam. And then if you press next and agree, you can just paste the code there and activate it. And every code can only be activated once, but we'll just keep dropping keys. So, people that are donating, some of them will receive biker keys this Monday when we get them.
Everyone who donates.
So they won't be released today during the streams, but you will get them, don't worry.
Yeah, so everyone who donates goes into a pool, and we will draw this Monday, and they will get the new biker DLCs. So, did you have a question, Hobo?
Yeah. Okay, so mine is... So, you know the Hoxton breakout heist, did you have anything to do with that one?
When I started at Overkill, that was like under development as well, together with Hotline Miami. And I like, you know, when we play together as level designers in a team, we always like give feedback to each other and like how we can improve the levels and so forth.
And also criticize each other, I guess.
Pretty much. No, but... I gave some feedback to how the level could do, like... You know, shortened drill times, and you know, that's I remember that because we had longer drill times. I think we had more computers to hack as well for Hoxton, I think we shortened that as well. But yeah, I only gave some input and helped out testing it before the release.
Yeah.
Okay, so that wasn't real all of my question. There's another part to it. So in the heist, like when you just get out of the first building, there is where you break them out. There's like a store or something in front of it. And like as a hockey poster in the window, was that like a mistake or was it planned?
I think that was something that our level artist might have placed or someone did. But I mean, I guess we reuse assets here and there, but maybe that was intentional. Or I don't remember.
Maybe they just placed it there as a joke.
Yeah. Okay. And the Elmer's toast and the Elmer's beard was like, who came up with that idea for like, was it himself or someone else?
The toast itself, I think it came from another level designer, Carrot. A long time ago when the bank heists were in development, and I think that toast was placed as a joke. But I'm not quite sure who came up with the idea, but I expanded on it. I started placing it like it expanded on White Christmas, and we made that big toast.
Yeah.
I think that was an idea from QA. They would love to see like something very rare in the level that would appear, and from then
we, like, beard.
I mean, and then from there we kept going on with the toast, like a fun little thing, like hiding it in new levels, and that's kind of like an in-house joke from us.
Oh, but no, you found me again.
Yeah, I placed it one.
Yeah.
I had to change it, move it, because it was too easy to find.
I was feeling bad for the toast. We were just finding it all the time.
I'm thinking about patching it again. I must hide it better.
Mm-hmm. The community will find it, you know that. No matter where you find it.
I found it in the Baker Heist also.
There have always been hidden things in, but like it started with the hockey poster, I think, already, that you had to find.
Yeah.
But about the beard, I think that was also an idea from QA.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know who came up with that.
Or the Almir bobblehead.
Some funny guy.
Yeah, I think that was also an idea from QA.
Question from Sorium. Is it possible for a survival heist to be made to see how long you can survive?
Yeah, I mean, that's something we've been wanting to do for a long time. And that's something I've seen the community have been wanting. We definitely have something in the scope for that. Maybe sometime in the future, but nothing really like planned or anything. But we want to try to make it happen, but I can't promise anything.
Question from the true Captain Crunch. Will we see something similar to the Hoxton Breakout heist, in the sense of unlocking the character after the heist?
Oh yeah. I mean, that's a really interesting idea. I'm trying to think. No, I don't think we have anything in this scope. Or, I don't know, actually. So I can't really give you... That's a kind of boring answer, but...
Yeah, that's fine.
I was actually going to ask one question, Peter, if that's okay.
Yeah.
You touched on it a little earlier, I think, about the mother of all heists and such. Towards the end of, supporting of Payday 2, will there ever be maybe something that's going to be like the final thing for Payday, like a final heist, sort of? Like maybe the only 3-day heist or something. Fort Knox, yeah. Fort Knox or something like that.
It's probably going to be the space heist. No, I'm kidding. I mean, Payday is still alive and growing, and I think the game is going to be lasting for a long time. So until that day happen, I think we will come up with something, or that's just what I think, but we'll see what can happen.
No, I was just wondering, like, a good send-off to the series.
Yeah,
like that.
I think until
maybe Payday 3 in the future or something like that.
Yeah, I think that's a really good idea. That's something we should do, but yeah, I don't know.
Yeah. Okay, sorry, Payday. Yeah, you can
no problem. There are so many questions, like, we could probably go on for hours.
Alright, go ahead.
Question from Arai. Will you make new bank heist or upgrade the existing classic ones?
Like make them, or?
Yeah, make new bank heists or upgrade the existing classic ones.
It depends. What do you mean with upgrading?
I guess I don't know what he means.
maybe he means like, you know, in first world bank that the vault entrance is in different locations.
Or improve the security.
That wasn't in the original, I don't know.
Yeah, I guess adding more random elements or something.
Yeah, I guess that's what he means.
Yeah, it's not planned either, but I mean, as you saw like a couple months ago, we added the achievement for kidnapping those two guys in the bank heist.
Mm-hmm.
And that was essentially for a side job. So I can see something like that happening to older levels. I mean, it's a really fun thing to do. It's nice to revive the old levels.
I remember when we first heard of the whole side job activity to be released, a lot of people thought they would be something like things that would be added to the level. Like, for example, those two people that you can take hostage, they would only appear when the daily job would appear. Or something like that. And it would be in other levels and such.
Yeah. I think that's something we wanted for that particular achievement. But due to, you know, technical stuff, it'd be kind of like we would be forced to, like, release a patch to make it happen.
Yeah,
and that would just be annoying for our users to download a patch every time a side job comes up.
Yeah,
it's better to just keep it in there.
Will there be an expansion to an underused contact like Lock, Jimmy, and the Butcher? Well, it's kind of the same question as we already asked earlier.
Oh yeah, I think that probably will happen. I mean, we kind of have like struggle with the contractors. Like we're getting so many Vlad missions and so forth, and we want to try to enrich the other contractors more. But also, you know, develop the stories behind them and so forth. So I think that probably will happen.
Okay. One thing: if you want like a better chance for your question to get answered, then you should tag Mr. Payday. I think it's Cashnet,
yeah.
Mr. Payday.
It's Cashnet _ Mr. Payday. I'll
and
post
you can
something
also
in the chat right now.
You can also tag Cashnet Live, so yeah, the one we're streaming with right now. So just tag that one for a better chance.
Let's see.
About slow mode, I don't think it's something we can do unless you're a partner or anything. But if you guys know, just tag Cashnet and say to me.
Yeah.
Everyone ready?
Okay, now we're getting a lot of questions directed at me. Are you going to do anything about cheaters? Like a VAC game ban or eject, maybe a cheater wipe? I don't know if you can answer that.
Yeah, that's probably going to be something I can't answer. I haven't been part of the discussions for those kind of things. I'm mostly focusing on levels.
Okay. Will you make the bikes easier to control? From Sulimation.
Please.
I think we will try to do it. It's been very hard to make those bikes behave as good as they are.
They get stuck on so much. They get stuck on a wall really easily.
I believe we released a patch this Friday for that.
Mm.
But I think we will probably continue doing that and improve that mechanic. But that's not really for sure either. But I think probably.
Will there be another vehicle-based level or more vehicle-based levels?
Probably. Probably.
Not planned.
I don't want to spoil anything either. So.
Yeah, I understand.
You're gonna drive a boat. Drive an aircraft. A spaceship,
yeah. Like, people were asking for a heist in space and a moon base heist and stuff like that. It's kind of crazy.
It's an infinite warfare, man.
They will
find
you on your moon base.
Yeah, they will find me there. The Illuminati.
Illuminati moon base.
A personal question for you. What is your favorite heister and your least favorite heister?
My favorite heister would probably be Dragon, because I just love that actor. Mm. And he's also partly Swedish, so I enjoy that. And also the movies he's been on. So I think that's probably my favorite. And the least favorite... I like them all so equally. But
Wolf, all the way.
No, Wolf is awesome. Or if that's what you meant, yeah.
Yes, Wolf is awesome. That's what I mean.
Oh yeah, there was another question about Wolf, now that you're talking about it. If he will get a new voice actor.
Oh, right.
I guess that's not your department, but maybe you can answer.
Yeah, that's... Yeah, exactly, it's not part of my field either. But I'm sure that would probably happen at some point. I mean, we are kind of trying to add more voice interaction to the levels, because that's something we really enjoy, and me personally.
That was one of the best parts of Pay the Heist also. The fact that the characters were talking to each other, like when they entered a new room and such.
Yeah, that's awesome. But since there's so many characters, it's very hard to do it right now.
Yeah.
But we try to...
And that leads to another question I have, Payday, if I may.
Sure.
Okay, so... do you feel that you're maybe working yourselves into a corner by adding so many voice actors and new characters to the game, that when Payday 3 comes out, maybe that's going to be a bit difficult to apply all of them?
Oh, wow. That's so far ahead in the future. I don't...
Yeah.
But I don't think so. I'm sure they have a good plan. And when I say they, I mean the producers and so forth who are driving the game forward.
Yeah.
I'm sure they have a plan for it. But that's not something I'm part of.
Okay.
Someone asks, will there be an underwater heist? Maybe a sunken ship with a hidden treasure.
How is the swimming going to work?
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah,
but
I think that's probably what
it's
going to
be.
Scuba
diving animations?
Yeah.
Yeah, adding new animations to our game is very expensive.
Dor is asking for harpoon guns.
Yeah.
No, as you said, probably not because of all the animation work and
Mr. Beta, one of my friends, he said the key grabbing is a really poor tactic. You should do a better way of doing the giveaways.
Yeah.
So how should I do it? Because I can't say pick a number between 0 and 1,000, because there's 700 people watching. I mean...
What the fuck are they? Wait,
how should we do that?
So, don't give any more away until this heist is done, I would say.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, fuck. Oh, it's Deadwish. I didn't even know. I thought it was still Okill, that's why.
I don't know.
Okay. What is the hardest part about designing a new heist?
That's a good question. I like that. Hardest part... I think, finishing the level and actually releasing it is the hardest. because there's so many things that come up at the end of the release that we don't really expect so early on, because there's so many skills and stuff hidden in the game that not all level designers are aware of, and that can come as a surprise, like just a week before release. Even though we plan ahead, we started doing that, and try to expect those kind of surprises. It still happens, and that makes us crunch a lot at the release. So I think like wrapping up the bag during the process of making a new level is what's the hardest.
Liz messaged me a question. How do you make the final vault reward of the heist feel rewarding? Like opening a vault door, how do you make that feel exciting?
I guess really exciting when you're waiting for the drill or thermal drill to, you know, open up the vault, and all the effects that happens when you open up the vault, all the sounds and, you know, dust falling down from the particles and stuff, and the sounds
and the sound.
Yeah, and you know that thing.
Yeah, I love that. We just played the Big Bang, and it had like that really nice sound.
Yeah, it's just the like anticipation up to that point, like you, now it's finally time to get the money.
Yeah, the sound plays a big part.
Yeah.
How many questions do we have, Petty?
A lot in the chat. Like, I'm trying to filter them and find the best ones, because a lot of questions are not focused on level design, but like general questions. And a lot of questions about Payday 3, like when will Payday 3 come out?
Yeah, we have bank guys.
Yeah, we're not gonna talk about that tonight.
Also, we got two donators. I forgot to say one of the donators actually. It is Team Secret. I think it's that.
Yeah, Team Dark Secret
Angel. He said, good luck, guys. Angel, this the Secret Crew's manager. Avani Maze, I don't know how to pronounce that. Maze Grove. Wow. He says, let's make it rain. And he donated one euro. Thank you so much, man.
Yeah, thank you.
I'll repeat the rewards, if you can call them that, for donating again.
Wait, I got one question from the chat about the goat heist. Was it like an idea you came up with, or was it them? They wanted the collaboration. Like, how did that idea like get made? You know.
Yeah. That idea came a long, long, long time ago. That I think that was in the process before I even started at Overkill. And we've been wanting to do that for a long time, and we've been like, you know, postponing it. And then I heard of the idea, and I picked up the level, and I wanted to do it, because I think it just sounds hilarious. Like, it sounds like a fun project to work on. And it was really fun to work on it. And I think personally it turned out great. It's just like the silliness around it during the release. I wasn't a big fan of that. I kind of wanted the heist to be more realistic. I mean, they do use drug mules or animals to.
Well, Petty has kind of moved away from the realistic end during its development.
That you're talking about me.
I mean, yeah, I feel like Payday has always been, you know, it has that glimpse in the eye, if that makes sense. Like, it's not really realistic. It's not a simulator.
No,
I think
it has its charm in its silliness, but you kind of roleplay as if it would be in a realistic sense, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah, I understand.
Right now there's a lot of spam going on in the chat.
Yeah,
because we're doing a raffle, so people have to type raffle to enter the raffle to win DLC keys. So all I'm seeing right now is like 200 raffle messages. Mm-mm-mm-mm. Will you guys ever make a large player heist, like a six-man heist, or even eight players?
Oh, that would be cool.
Oh yeah.
There was a mod that was for like 13 mm-hmm. or 14 players.
Yeah, I saw that, but that's just chaotic.
Yeah, I think that's probably why we haven't done it. It's way too chaotic, and it's hard to design levels around that. It's even hard right now as it is with four players to make it. To make the flow feel right. And there's been so many times when we've made two big levels and the players spread around too much and the combat doesn't feel right. Because, you know, at some points all cops are focusing on one player. And there's something one I try to avoid, and I can't imagine how hard it would be to get a balanced gameplay with eight players.
Imagine eight players, rocket launcher and miniguns. The poor bulldozers. They wouldn't have a chance.
I have a question, what is the longest time it has taken for you to make... Like, what is the longest time it has taken you to make a heist? Like, the hardest heist to make?
The longest, at least for me personally, was the Goat Simulator heist. But before that, I've heard from other people that the casino and Big Bank, obviously because they're so big, have been really hard to make. And Alesso was also very hard because it's also so big. And especially like, you know, when you have big heists like that, where it's one day and it's got both stealth and loud and it's really big, that becomes really hard, because when we design our levels, we're only one person per level designing. And I mean, making a really big level, that kind of feels like two levels, and then also adding stealth to it multiplies by two. And one level designer has to take care of all of that, and it becomes really hard to design, you know, objectives working for stealth and then objectives working for loud, and then you have to be able to transition in the middle of anywhere to go back to go to loud if you know fail. So that's probably the hardest and most time consuming ones that we made.
It was a 2-day heist also, like, but both of them were loud, but making two heists at all, it's like making two different maps.
If we go back to God Simulator, for me personally, it was really tricky because it was, as you said, two levels that I worked on at the same time. And that's really hard because you can't have two levels up at the same time. So you have to kind of go back and forth. And I did get a lot of help from other level designers to back me up. But I still had, you know, I was still driving the levels, like...
Okay, so the rewards for donating, I'll name them again because there are some new viewers watching now. The top donation gets a Payday 2 loot bag with a signed Deadass mask, signed by the Overkill developers, a money bundle, a t-shirt, and the Deadass Wolf and Chains metal pins. And then the second and third highest donators get the new game Dead by Daylight on Steam. And also everyone that donates at least $1 will enter in a raffle to win the new biker DLCs, which will be sent out this Monday. So next question. When starting to make a heist, are you given a specific design to make, or are you given free rein over the design and map layout?
Usually we get like from producers kind of like a frame that we have to keep inside. So if I take the Goat Simulator heist, for instance, when I designed the levels, all I knew was that it had to have goats. And so from there on, everything else is up to us, to level designers, to do. So we, you know, we get a frame and then we try to stick to it and we design from there. So mostly it's our own ideas. And we always...
Did you come up with the concept also why you had to steal the goats?
Yeah. But that's also like...
That's the silly part of it.
When we design levels, we as a team always group up together and we share our ideas, and then eventually we all agree and like it, and from there on we proceed.
Okay. Caboose just donated, and he said, reason, no reason.
Reason, no reason.
Thank you very much, Caboose.
Yeah, we love you.
Thank you.
We love you.
And if you don't know, he's a Cashed member.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but yeah.
I like this question. Have there ever been heists inspired by real life crimes?
Ooh.
That's a good question.
Or will there be?
I'm sure a lot of the heists made have taken inspiration from real stuff. Like when I designed the Gold Simulator, I remember I was reading a newspaper, a local one here from Sweden, where a truck full of chickens had like fallen down on the highway, and all the chicken ran around and spread around. Although they didn't have cocaine stuffed up in them, but I mean, you can imagine that some people are doing that. I'm sure it happens.
Was that a heist? Did they just steal chickens, or did they just want to mess with the chickens? What happened?
No, I'm sure that was just an accident. But I don't know. Maybe they did steal. Maybe it's a cover up. I don't know. Illuminati.
Illuminati. Actually, I think it's more like the other way around. Like people try to do the heist in real life.
Yeah. They learn from Payday and then they try to do it in real life.
I saw a video once, like last year, someone in the United States was robbing a store with a Dallas mask on.
Oh yeah, I saw that as well.
Yeah, did you see that?
Oh really? Yeah. I haven't seen that one.
Actually pretty, not funny, but like unique. But you actually have real life heisters now.
Yeah, I don't think Andreas answered the question, actually.
Wait, which question?
Has there or will be heists based on real crimes?
Yeah, I mean, there was this one heist here in Sweden where, I think it was the first one where they used helicopters to rob a place.
Yeah, I know that, yeah.
Mm. Yeah, the helicopter robbery. And
that's famous.
That sounds like an awesome idea, but I think at some point back in the days before I joined, that they tried to make something similar like that.
Mm.
But, I mean, in real life, a heist isn't really that interesting. It's always so quick, and it's always, you know, it's over in like a minute, and it's hard to base a real level out of that. And I think that's why it was scrapped, essentially. Or maybe it's not scrapped, I don't know. But,
maybe some would find it offensive or something, I don't know.
Yeah, maybe that too. It's just like weird to base it off of real things. And, as I said, it probably won't be a fun level either.
And in real life you don't have a Bane giving you directions through a headset or earpiece. Yeah.
Well, I mean, some part of the fun in Payday is the simplicity of it. Get into a place, steal everything, and get out. So, maybe that will work.
Yeah, but then again, 1 minute heist.
Yeah.
Okay, we got someone called Question. I think it's because he wants a question answered. And he said he donated €1. And he said, why isn't there any support for the console versions of Payday? I don't think he can answer that, to be honest. So.
Thank you for the donation, though.
Yeah, thank you for the donation, though. Yeah. But, yeah. I don't know.
Do you know anything about that, Andreas?
The what?
The console.
No.
Hey, do you have any questions, Mr. Payday?
Yeah, I got a few more. Okay. Speaking about balance, how do you balance maps in such a way that it doesn't become too much of a cop grinder, but not feel like it's made in the cop's favor?
when we balance levels, at least for me personally, and I try to encourage others to do it, is to try to make it as hard as possible. Like, just like try to spam so many cops as possible. And out from there, it's easy to just disable spawns and until it feels right. Like, when we play in-house, we always play on overkill. And as a level designer, all the QA tests all difficulties, of course. But as us level designers, we kind of try to balance it out from overkill. And if overkill feels too hard, we just disable spawns. And if it feels too easy, we re-enable them.
Okay, I got a few more good questions here. Will you make a map that will be based on solving a puzzle?
Do you mean like
the diamond?
The diamonds?
Yeah, but like, I think they mean like a complete map just filled with only puzzles.
Wouldn't that be kind of strange though, if you play public?
Yeah,
I agree. Because we all know how the diamond public goes.
So yeah, maybe one day, but yeah.
A lot of people are asking this, how many people do you have working on Payday 2 in total?
I think we maybe are around 70 or something. There's so many people around.
How many people worked at Overkill to begin with?
There's
quite a lot now.
I think the studio started with like 7 people or something.
Oh wow.
Yeah, I remember in Payday really the heist, they had like 15 to 20 maybe.
Yeah.
But we are also working on many, many levels at the same time. Mm-hmm. And we divide, you know, the people into groups. So we can, you know, make levels at the same time. And the levels now are becoming so big, they become bigger. And that takes a lot more time for us to make. Which requires more people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, especially the ones with multiple days, of course.
Yeah.
And around it, you also have a story to write, like about the heist. You gotta get voice actors to do new lines and all that stuff. A lot of work to just get a heist.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. It really is.
Because you can make the map, but then you need to have all the things around the map. Yeah, like the concepts for everything and the voice acting and yeah.
Mm-hmm. This guy has a really cool idea here. Will you guys make player versus player heist that you can raid all your players' safe house?
Oh.
Player versus player heist.
Yeah, like you can attack their safe house and steal a certain percentage of money from them.
That would go, because that would go kind of against the whole cooperative nature of
Payday. Yeah,
indeed.
Because I've always enjoyed the Payday because of the cooperation you need to have.
If you make it optional, I think if you add like a versus mode, I think you'll get even a wider audience than you currently have. Because they go, more people will be attracted to the game then.
Yeah, but also at the same time, there's so many skills that, you know, are based off of the fact that you play against AI, like, you know, Stockholm Syndrome or, you know, dominating or so forth, so...
You get a speed boost when you do a headshot or, you know, like...
Yeah, then you gotta redesign the skill tree again.
that would be so nice.
Yeah. It would be
unfair.
You guys ever made a map that only works in debug mode? Like, just for yourself, for your own pleasure, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, we do that all the time. We always have test levels in debug mode with just, you know, blocked out geometry, just so we can test out new features and stuff like that. We actually have one test level called Test Bed from IKEA.
And IKEA! Of course. Steal the meatballs and the furniture.
Are you kidding with us right now?
Am I? I don't know.
No, I really want to play that.
Send Payday the files.
Please.
Yes.
I think it's what someone who were joking a lot. But that's pretty much it.
Okay, I got a question. How long do you plan to stick with Overkill?
And I'm really enjoying working there, so as long as I can.
Okay.
What was the worst heist ID you guys ever had?
I mean, worst ideas. I don't think we've ever released a level that we haven't agreed on and that we liked together. So, and all the scrapped levels that we have, we don't really remember them. I barely remember any scrapped levels that we have. So,
okay, I think that was it. You need to leave, right?
Yeah, you have to leave.
Yeah. That was it, man. Thank you for coming, man.
Yeah, thank you,
thanks,
Andreas.
Too. It's really fun. I hope to do this again.
Yeah, it was really awesome to have you here, man.
Yeah, it was.
All right, guys.
Have a good one.
Yeah, thanks. You too, guys. Yeah.
See you.
Bye-bye.
See you later.
Bye-bye.
Bye.